up, guys? It's your girl, Brooklyn, and welcome to my channel. Thank you guys so much for clicking on today's video. I want to start out by saying that the random cooing noises that you hear in the background are my daughter. She just woke up from her nap, but I'm really hoping that she lets me film this video because it is long awaited and long overdue. You can probably put two and two together that I am and no longer pregnant. Yes, I filmed this video months ago. I was actually editing my What's in My Hospital Bag vlog and realized that 95% of the footage from said video is just gone. It has completely vanished. I have no idea where it is. It is not on my computer, it is not on my camera, and it is not on my hard drive. So yes, I am refilming this video. I was slightly frustrated, but you know what? It actually works out great. I've already been through the process and I can show you guys what I originally took with me to the hospital and what I actually use. So you know what? We're gonna look on the brighter side of things and just go with the flow. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you do, please be sure to give this video a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe because it really helps support my channel, and let's just hop into this video. I'm gonna go ahead and apologize because the lighting is probably gonna change a lot throughout this video. It's kind of overcast outside and clouds keep going in front of the sun. We're gonna work with what we've got. If you see me looking down at my phone, it is because before having a child, back when I had all the time in the world, I took the time to actually type out every single thing that was on my hospital bag list, and I have that photo on my phone. So I want to make sure that I tell you guys every little thing that I brought, even though I might not have used it, because who knows, maybe something that I didn't use you'll want to use and you'll find helpful. So for starters, I actually ended up using three separate bags. So I packed all of Charlie's things in her diaper bag, and then I put my things separately in my own bag, and then I put all of Danny's things in his own bag. Now, some people might think this is a bit excessive. You might want to put everything in one bag, and that is totally fine. I found it easier to bring three separate bags, mainly because say I needed something for Charlie, instead of having to rummage through a bag that had all three of our belongings in it, I knew that everything that I needed for her was in her own bag. I knew exactly where it was in the bag, so it just made it a lot easier. But again, that might be a bit over the top. You don't need to bring three different bags if you don't want to. I just found it easier for myself. Okay, so I'm just gonna go ahead and start off with Charlie's diaper bag. I ended up being gifted the diaper bag that I had on my registry, the brand Miss Fong. This is actually a really good, affordable brand, and it's good dupes for like the really, really expensive ones. A lot of the diaper bags that of course I loved and wanted were in the $200-$400 range, and ain't nobody trying to spend that kind of money on a diaper bag. And I was really adamant about wanting a backpack diaper bag. I just wanted something that was lightweight, that could hold all of our stuff, that would be easy for me to just throw on and go quickly. And I can definitely say I highly recommend this backpack. I'm currently almost 6 weeks postpartum and I have loved it. And I am gonna go ahead and say that everything I talk about in this video will be linked down below for you guys, so if y'all need or want any of it. So the first thing that is on my list for her was onesies. I wanted to make sure that I brought enough clothes for her. I was terrified that the newborn sizes were not going to fit her. Y'all, let me just save y'all some time and space in your bag. You do not need a million different onesies, and you definitely don't need them in multiple sizes. I packed like 3 to 4 onesies of each size, newborn sizes and size 0 to 3. You don't need that much. That is way, way, way too much. The majority of the time we did skin to skin, so she was in a diaper naked like 95% of the time. And when she wasn't, she was swaddled. So you're not gonna need a ton of onesies. You're not gonna need a ton of clothes. I know you get excited, I did. I would say 2, maybe 3 onesies is all you need, and like her going home outfit. And that's it. Another thing that I overpacked on was sleepers and gowns. And realistically, you're not even gonna need them. I was only in the hospital for 2 days and she didn't wear any of her nightgowns that I brought her. I will recommend bringing swaddle blankets. I overpacked and I brought like 3 or 4 really cute swaddle blankets. She didn't even use any of them. She used the hospital swaddle blankets the whole time. Unless you're wanting to take cute pictures, then bring 1, maybe 2. For example, her announcement photo that we chose to do, we actually used a swaddle blanket that she was gifted for her baby shower, and it just had her name all over it. She was only in that swaddle blanket for the amount of time it took us to take the photos, and then we took her out of it and put her back in the hospital one. Going along with her clothes items, I brought a ton of socks, hand mittens, beanies, and I brought bows. Literally didn't use any of them. Like I said, she was legit in a diaper and a swaddle blanket pretty much the whole time. And again, we were only there for 2 days. I would bring 1, maybe 2 pairs of socks for your baby's coming home outfit. if it's a little girl, then maybe one bow and or beanie. And then same with little boy, like maybe one beanie for like some cute photos or for his coming home outfit. But other than that, you're not gonna use any of it. I'm telling you, you're gonna be so tired and so out of it that the last thing you're gonna wanna do is dress your baby up in cute clothes when they're just gonna sleep. I packed it. Not needed. We also ended up bringing a lot of diapers with us and wipes. We didn't use a single diaper or a single wipe that we brought ourselves. Again, the hospital gives them to you. Because I packed all of her stuff in her diaper bag, I went ahead and packed her diaper bag how I would be using it on a normal everyday basis, like once we bring her home. So I went ahead and put her diapers and her wipes in her bag, but again, we didn't use them. Ain't nobody trying to use wipes and diapers of your own. So one thing that I would highly recommend bringing is a boppy or a nursing pillow. I was surprised at how much I actually used this in the hospital. I didn't think I was gonna use it that much, but I used it a ton, even when she wasn't nursing and she was just laying in my arms. And another thing that I brought with me was lotion for her and Binkies. We didn't end up using the lotion at all. When they did bathe her, they just put their lotion on her. I didn't even get to bathe her. They took her away in the middle of the night while I was sleeping. I wouldn't even bother bringing that. And I brought Binkies with her, and I brought several different kinds because I wasn't sure, one, if she would even take a Binky, but two, if she did take a Binky, which type of Binky she was gonna take. But again, she didn't even use a Binky the whole time she was there. So, and the last thing that we brought for her was a car seat cover and then her car seat. Obviously, those are needed. You don't need a cover. I would recommend them, you know, especially with what's going on in the world. I don't know. I just preferred it. It's totally your call. So that is all that we brought for Charlie. So all I would really recommend bringing for baby is two, maybe three onesies, a pair of socks, one bow and or beanie, one swaddle blanket, maybe a sleeper or a gown if you're feeling up for it, a nursing pillow, car seat cover, and car seat. And honestly, that's all you really need. Oh, hang on.
I'm mommy. They don't want to be held.
Okay. Sorry about that.
Mommy, Charlie's making her YouTube debut.
She's very, very good at holding her head up nowadays. She likes to look around, so.
We're gonna see if we can do this when mommy holds you.
The next thing that I will talk about is what I brought in my bag. And again, I way overpacked for myself. A lot of the stuff that I brought in my hospital bag, I actually packed before knowing that I was gonna have to have a scheduled C-section. Some of the stuff that I brought with me, you actually need for a vaginal delivery, but I still used some of it. Let me just not confuse you, let me explain. Obviously, the first thing that I brought, because I wanted to film everything, was a camera and my camera charger. So I would definitely say bring those. And then I also brought my Polaroid camera just so I could take a few Polaroid pictures of her. Oh, but you don't need that. It's not a necessity. I will say I brought chapstick with me. I saw this in another YouTube video and I'm so glad that I did, because the worst thing on the planet is having chapped lips and needing chapstick and not having it. And you're just like, you need it. You need it, right? And then you don't have it. That's the worst. That's the worst. So yeah, I would definitely recommend bringing chapstick. I ended up bringing a toiletry bag with me. So I found this little bag at Target. I just thought it was the cutest thing. So I brought toothbrush and toothpaste. I ended up bringing shampoo and conditioner, but they have some there that they give you. So technically you don't need to bring that if you don't want to, but you can. And then I also brought some body wash with me. I went and actually bought a loofah from Target. It was like $2. I would highly recommend bringing a loofah. It's amazing, gets the job done. So yeah, I would definitely get that. It was super cheap at Target. And then the last few things I brought with me were lotion, my makeup, makeup remover, and a hairbrush. I would definitely say bring a hairbrush. I ended up braiding it for my surgery, and oh good lord, it took me forever to brush the knots out of my hair. All I really brought with me makeup-wise to the hospital was mascara and a little bit of bronzer. I didn't want to bring a ton of makeup because I had a feeling I wasn't gonna really care to do my makeup. It was gonna be the last thing on my mind, but I wanted to feel like an actual human being, so I didn't want to look completely busted, but I also knew that I wasn't going to be doing a glam full face of makeup either. Another thing that I would highly recommend is bringing a water bottle. Oh my Lanta, that was a lifesaver for me. I didn't want to drink hospital water. I know that sounds stupid, maybe a little prima donna, but I definitely would recommend bringing a water bottle with you. And then another thing that I brought with me was my prenatal vitamins. I knew, especially with breastfeeding, that I was going to continue taking my prenatals after having her. So I actually ended up bringing two separate nightgowns with me. So I brought this one nightgown that is kind of a thicker material. It's really soft. I got it from Target. It's just like a dress. And then the other nightgown that I brought was a set. So it was like a top and a bottom, like a short set, both of which, as you can tell, actually unbutton. And I would highly recommend getting some sort of outfit that is going to unbutton for you, especially if you're breastfeeding. It's going to make it so much easier. But both of these gowns were lightweight, super loose, and felt really good, which was a must for me, especially with the shorts being high-waisted because I had a C-section, and the last thing that I wanted was anything anywhere near my incision. And then I ended up bringing slippers with me. Honestly, I didn't even need them. I didn't use them because I wasn't up walking, especially the first day because of the surgery itself. And the second day, I hardly got out of bed at all. I only got out of bed to go to the restroom when they would come in, and I just used the socks. I was not about to worry about putting on slippers when it came to getting out of bed. I wanted to get to the toilet and back as quick as possible. I was in so much pain. And then I ended up bringing a robe with me, but if I'm being honest, I didn't even use it. I hardly even used my nightgown. I pretty much stayed in the hospital gown. We actually ended up bringing our own pillows with us. I'm really glad that we did, especially for Danny, because the hospital pillows just aren't all that great. He slept on the little couch area that they had in there for us. So I definitely would recommend bringing your own pillows and blankets. And then I ended up bringing nipple cream for myself. Honestly, I didn't even use the nipple cream until a few days after getting home, but it's definitely not a bad item to have just in case. If you are breastfeeding, everybody's breastfeeding journey is different. So just because I didn't need it while I was in there doesn't mean that you won't need it. I honestly can't remember if they had nipple cream for me at the hospital, but I know that I brought some of my own with me, but I didn't use it. Some things that I had purchased before knowing that I was gonna need a C-section are these next few items, and I brought them with me. The Frida Perry bottle, and then I got the Frida Mom cooling pad liners. I would recommend them if you have a vaginal delivery. I didn't need the cooling pad liners because obviously down there for me wasn't all messed up. The Perry bottle I definitely could have used, but the hospital actually gave me this little water bottle, which I used the whole time. So because they already had that like ready to go in the bathroom for me, I didn't even bother pulling mine out, but I would have needed it if they didn't give me that. So I would definitely say, regardless of having a C-section, I still would have used the Perry bottle. Another thing that I brought with me but didn't use were the Always Discreet undies. I used those once I got home, but while I was in the hospital, they actually gave me a ton of pads and a ton of bottoms, and I really liked the bottoms that they gave me, so I just wore those the whole time, and I even wore those for a little bit after getting home. But on days where I didn't feel like removing a pad and putting a pad back on, I just wore the Discreet undies, and those are really nice because it's kind of like Depends. You just pull them up and you're good to go. And if I'm being real honest with you guys, for the first week and a half, that is all I wore. I didn't wear my own underwear. I didn't wear shorts. I didn't wear a nightgown. I literally just wore a nursing bra and those Discreet undies and or the pads and bottoms that the hospital gave me. Speaking of nursing bras, I would definitely recommend getting you a nursing bra. You're gonna need it. Going into the hospital, I only had one. After getting home, I actually went to Target and ended up buying several more. I would definitely recommend getting a few because they get worn down pretty easily because you're practically living in the same outfit for multiple days in a row with a newborn. But I only brought one with me to the hospital and it worked perfectly fine. And then with the nursing bras, you're gonna need nursing pads because you get the leaking real quick. Like, I didn't start leaking that bad though until after I came home. Now I'm leaking constantly. Another thing that everybody told me I was gonna need were nipple ice packs. So I brought some with me. I didn't even use them. Again, that's something that you're not really gonna need until maybe like a week later. You know, once baby's been nursing for like a week straight constantly, that's when your nipples really start getting sore and sensitive, kind of chafed and scabbed up. So I didn't need any of that. And it's not a bad item to have. Just because I didn't use it and I didn't need it in the hospital doesn't mean that you won't. Everybody's experience is gonna be different. And then the last few things, I've got a pair of like really cheap flip-flops for the shower because I didn't want to stand in the shower barefoot. And then I just brought a maxi dress to come home in. I brought two different outfits because I wasn't sure how I was gonna be feeling, but I ended up just wearing a simple maxi dress. That way I didn't have anything pushing or touching on my incision. Something cute but simple and light where you're gonna feel comfortable in, because trust me, you're not gonna wanna get all dressed up. So we ended up packing a bag for Danny. And his bag was so simple and so easy. With our situation, we didn't even need to pack him a bag because we had to leave our dogs at home and we didn't have anyone who could watch them. So Danny was having to come home multiple times throughout the day and throughout the night to let the dogs out. So he would leave really early in the morning to come home, feed the dogs, and let the dogs out. And then he would come back to the hospital with me. Then he'd come home sometime during the afternoon to let them out again and spend a little time with them. And then he came back to the hospital, and then pretty late at night he would go back home to feed them and let them out one last time to tide them over until he came back in the morning. He ended up coming home quite a bit, so he really didn't even need his bag. The first time he came home, he actually ended up bringing his bag back because he would just shower and change and everything here at the house, because why not? I would have too. But I'll go ahead and tell y'all what he brought. He brought a pair of comfy clothes that he could sleep in. He brought a jacket with him just in case it was cool in the hospital, but he didn't end up needing it. A pair of socks, a water bottle for himself, and his phone and phone charger. And then for his toiletries, shampoo and body wash and conditioner, and then like deodorant and all of that fun stuff, just like your random miscellaneous things that you need. But again, he didn't end up using them because he just came home and showered. Like I said earlier, a pillow and some blankets. And then I made a miscellaneous list for like the random little things that we were gonna need. We brought like cash for the vending machine so we could get snacks. We brought our own snacks with us, but those went pretty quickly. We brought hand sanitizer, even though the hospital has hand sanitizer. We ended up bringing my laptop so we can watch movies, and then my laptop charger, and that was pretty much it. I would definitely recommend bringing snacks and some food. The hospital does come in and give you breakfast, lunch, and dinner, but that's only for the patient, aka mommy. So Danny had to leave and go get himself food anyways. The hospital food, it wasn't bad, but it wasn't all that great. But Danny actually ended up bringing me food when he would come back each time. You don't need to bring cash for a vending machine and snacks if you're able to leave. I know some hospitals don't allow you to leave. Like once you come in, like that's it. But the hospital we were at, Danny was able to come and go as he pleased, but he was the only one that was allowed to visit me. We were definitely blessed in that sense. I would definitely check with your hospital, especially with everything that's going on right now in the world. Their policies are constantly changing. Their visitation's constantly changing. Okay guys, and just like that, we are done with today's video. If y'all were curious about what you may need for a C-section, or if you're curious just in general what you should bring, or if you just wanted to kind of double check over your list to make sure you had everything, I really hope this video helped you guys out, and I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please be sure to give this video a big thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe because it really helps support my channel, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!